Can't start this interview without asking you this question. How does it feel like to return to EG for the third time?
Well, it feels okay to be back in EG. Actually, this is hard to answer, man.
Oh my god. Yeah, I need to think about this.
So I'm trying to think of something to say that I haven't said before about last time I left So it's actually quite hard.
So I'll ask you the question again now. How's it feel to be back to EG for the third time? Do you have any extra pressure or expectations?
I guess the most pressure I ever felt after replacing someone on EG was after they just won TI, and I think that went pretty well.
This time around, we have to step up as players and learn how to lead more. Both me and Crit have that responsibility, and more now compared to them. Because we lost Fear and PPD as players, who were both very crucial in our, you know, decision making.
As you're all from different backgrounds, how do you guys agree on ideas and training and stuff like that?
Well, the idea behind how Fnatic works and all, it seems very good right now. The fact, like, we have Mushi and Ohio from Malaysia, and we have two Filipinos, and right now it really comes a lot on Mushi because he's the most experienced player. And his knowledge, like, we're very, very open for criticism as well, which is going to help us excel in the future. This season, I'm very optimistic about it. Our goal is top three.
Well, it'd be nice to go to the grand finals for the third time, I can't lie, but I think we're capable of winning for sure. I also think we're capable of losing, so...
Alright, that's it. Awesome. Thanks.
Awesome.
Used to be the captain of the Dota team, and now I'm fixing the toilet. That's just how it goes. All right, what are we doing?
Wow.
What just happened? Where did that go? Where did that come from?
Have you done this before?
I've never done this before. I used to play Dota for millions of dollars. No one will ever believe me. Most people are kind of like surprised that I would leave the team. Especially because there wasn't really any signs of me like retiring, so I'm still like only 24 years old, and I've only been playing Dota for like 3 years, when other people have been playing for like close to a decade. But everyone's saying really nice things for the most part.
Someone's like, it's a good time for him. Yeah, 24. Yeah. He was about to get too old.
Gotta start settling down.
Yeah.
All right. I think we're good.
EG is just the whole front page today by the look of it.
Oh, I have an AMA request thread. I just saw it.
Look at this. Top comment of the AMA request. PPD will own EG one day. Mark my words.
That's an interesting philosophy. Who is that?
Whammy Barnett.
Whammy Barnett has some good insight.
Whammy Barnett. Smart.
Smart man.
Welcome back. You're going to be staying in your old room.
How exciting.
Yeah. It's a little cleaner than you left it, I believe.
A place I once called home.
I thought about it last year, to be honest, to retire, but I kind of still really wanted to play, and so I pushed myself through all my year, but I need to give myself, like, a proper break and heal my arm.
I don't know if you want to take, like, the outside or the inside.
Probably just the corner, maybe over there, away from everyone.
Away from everyone?
Yeah. I think I could definitely be happy being a coach, like, it's like the next best thing to playing. If I can do anything that'll still keep me close to the game and part of the competition, I probably will do it.
Right now, all the guys are preparing for their very first tournament as a
surprise,
team.
Surprise, surprise. Welcome back.
They're boot camping at our team house in Alameda.
Oh, this place is so fancy,
yeah?
And the idea of the boot camp is just for all of them to get together and figure out how exactly they want to play together.
Hey, you stole Peter's seat?
Is that Peter's seat?
You are the new Peter?
Dan, that's me.
You know, make sure that they're getting along and having fun, but also to just have like a very focused practice routine where they wake up, play a couple scrims, and at night they play pubs. Just really focus on just Dota and not have any other distractions.
Am I sitting here? I don't know.
Jimmy just arrived. He just texted me, hi. That's pretty much it, so.
What are you gonna text him back?
Where you at?
Let's go, man.
I didn't expect PPD to retire, dude.
You expected him?
No, I didn't expect that. I mean, I didn't see that coming.
I told you.
You told me?
Yeah, I told you PPD's out.
I thought you were joking, dude.
No, I wasn't.
Like, I was like, no, it just doesn't make sense to me. I mean, he's like fear in EG right now, you know? He's like the face of EG.
So what do we have aside from just photo shoot and that's it?
It's photo shoot, and then you guys are going to the island.
After the photo shoot, it's like, and
after the photo shoot,
looks like a zombie.
Don't worry, dude. They put makeup on you. It's all good.
You know you're very slow.
What?
You know you're very slow.
I know, I saw, I was like, what the fuck, you guys are already... I'm already...
So, our team had a massive change. I mean, we had a three-player change, which is a bit unfortunate, I suppose. We were hoping to rebuild the team around Amushi in Ohio. It was kind of tough to look for three players, especially in this shuffle, because this shuffle has been, very bluntly put, very messy. The messiest one I've ever seen. We don't know who is going where. It was insane, you know. At the end, Mushi likes to play with Demon Jimmy, and Jimmy's confirmation is pretty much Ayo's confirmation as well, because they are a support duo and they're supposed to stay together. And we picked Raven. Raven is probably the most stable carry in Philippines right now. The small problem about Raven is only his age, because he's 17. He's turning 18 in about a week time.
Yeah. I see the debit time when you get it right.
Yeah. The biggest challenge that the team is gonna face is basically playing to the level that the previous team played again. All the accomplishments took a lot of months to build. Small details, all the small details along the way took like a whole year to build. And basically reforming the team again like this, it means that we have to start from scratch again. And everything that we have done till now have to be redone again. And that's gonna be really, really difficult.
I mean, for us, this is our first time actually playing together, seriously, I would say. We did some online scrims before we got here, but the conditions weren't great.
Are you excited about sharing a room with
other people? I mean, we used to share rooms a lot. We shared rooms on Secret, occasionally on AD, so it's nothing new. Of course, having a solo room is nice, but
This is building team spirit, right? So, team morale.
I can't brush my teeth, sir.
There we go. I didn't know.
Go get us a rundown of what you got packed, man.
My mom packed for me, so I don't really know. Just got some shorts. Got enough clothing to last a couple of days, then I have to do laundry.
Do you know how to do laundry?
Yeah. Serious?
Just checking.
Shows you right here. It's like cool, pretty cool. Long sleeves. I think I'm the only Dota player with long sleeve jersey. Jacket from TI6. It's like super hard to think of any other nick. Like no one has their first name as their nick. So it's like pretty cool too. Just have something unique. So that's why I chose Sumil.
Can you tell us how you decided to pack what you packed?
I mean, I didn't even pack my bag. It was my mom. So, and like she put everything I had. So that's pretty much it.
We're headed over to the Chinese consulate to get visas for Ludwig, Andreas, and Sumail. This is a pretty standard part of the process.
You're gonna need two sets of passport photos, please.
The European countries don't get 10-year visas generally, so you have to renew them a couple times a year. And Sumail, who has a Pakistani passport, is a constant problem. So for every place that we travel, he has to go get a visa. It is a constant challenge, but well worth it for Sumail.
Have a good day. Appreciate it.
Who's the best singer right now?
Singer?
Yeah.
Right now?
Yeah. Personally, I like my boy Zane and then Bieber. And then who's there? Yeah, it's like not many, I guess.
I wouldn't say they're good singers.
Wait, what do you say?
I wouldn't say they're good singers.
Are you serious?
Their music is fine, but they're not like great singers.
All right, man.
That's just my opinion.
Did you see the ESPN article with Jeremy Lin and VG?
I didn't read it, but I saw it. It was only a matter of time, I think, until he invested in a team.
Who is Jeremy Lin?
Jeremy Lin is a, that's a great famous boy. NBA basketball player. He actually plays Dota.
Oh, he does?
Yeah, that's the thing. Like, he grew up like playing Dota like with his friends.
Oh, that's cool. So, like,
he's comparing NBA players to Dota heroes.
Wait, you're saying Razor is like...
Steph Curry.
Steph Curry.
No way. Oh, Kobe's
Juggernaut is Kobe.
I would say Kobe would be Juggernaut.
I could see that.
Yeah, we actually live on Haight-Ashbury. It's a pretty historic intersection for the city. Jimi Hendrix is right here. A block up the street is the Grateful Dead house, which I imagine people watching this probably won't even know who they are, but they're a pretty big monumental band for this area. You know, I myself don't really know them that well, but I listened to their music the other day when we were driving to Vegas. And
you're literally wearing a Haight-Ashbury shirt. What? And you're like, I don't know who the Grateful... Whatever.
Times are changing.
Whatever.
You act like everybody knows the Grateful Dead. You didn't even know the Grateful Dead.
Oh my God, I know the Grateful Dead. They were telling me how no one knows who Jimi Hendrix is. They're like, he's so like...
I'm not saying nobody knows who Jimi Hendrix is. I'm just saying like, if you asked like today's teenagers who Jimi Hendrix was, they probably would not know.
I feel like it's like Elvis. Like, I feel like everyone knows who Jimi Hendrix is.
No, he's not Elvis.
Unreal.
I don't know when I'm able to see her, and she never knows when she's gonna see me. It's like, I told her whenever an event in Canada or US, like I can come visit for a couple days.
It's hard, but at least you and I are making it work somehow.
But she's like, what's really a couple days when you're missing a month or two or whatever it is?
Good night.
I love you.
I love you too.
She graduates in June, and she told me it'd mean everything to her if I could make it, and told her it's like, I can't give you an... That's what kind of sucks sometimes, because like with Dota, you don't know how the season's going to be, what kind of tournaments are coming up. No one wants to be that guy to like, hey, like, let's call this off because I have something important to attend to. Well, yeah, I just hope we'll see what happens, but at the end of the day, it's It's pretty tough.
Roll toward the back. We're not going to fill it up. It's got a lot of seats, but...
You didn't shave, huh? Why would I shave, man? Girls dig mustaches. Word up.
What about half a mustache?
Work in progress.
Gotta start somewhere.
Here would be good. Right. Yeah, I've got everybody in a row. Awesome. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Dude, $6 million Earthshaker, Ecclesiastes, that's amazing. Dude, I jumped out of my seat when that happened. You remember that,
right? All right, everyone, who is ready to play with the best Dota team? You ready? Let's go!
How many games are we
doing? What? I have
no idea. I want to play all day.
He has a great mustache.
Yeah, you like it? Don't encourage him, man.
Wait, the cheats were on? Holy shit, cheats were on for last game. Wait, are we randoming or what?
I'm not randoming.
Come on.
I'm playing Butch, dude.
What? No, you can't play first. Yeah, it looks random, man.
I mean, I'm still going to do everything that I did before except for actually play. I'm just going to be like just in the background, you know, and just kind of just like helping them prepare for games. So I'll still be part of it without having to play, which is pretty cool. I don't know what I'm doing, guys.
Are you going jungle?
I don't know. I don't got jungle items.
I guess you're new.
All right.
Let him have it.
All right, Peter's getting a double-double. No lettuce,
No tomato.
And a cheeseburger.
We have a cheeseburger.
With everything.
Everything.
And animal style.
Animal style.
4x4 animal style.
4x4 animal style.
Then two double doubles, no tomato, no onion.
Small chocolate, dude.
A small chocolate milkshake.
Small chocolate milkshake, please.
You have a good day, boss.
Hey, thank you. That's everything? Perfect. Thank you.
In America, everything is finger food.
Are these the colors?
Yeah.
Maybe this.
What the fuck?
I'm so scared.
New hair, new life.
New hair, new life.
I never have this kind of hair before. I need polo hair.
Polo hair?
It's kind of very long.
Yeah, it's too long.
Is that long?
Yeah.
I think so. It's long and thick, you know?
Please make me look, how do you say handsome in Chinese? Leng Chai. Make me Leng Chai. Worst case, I just shave it all off. Oh no.
Very itchy.
Itchy?
Yeah, it's itchy. Itchy as fuck.
I've never dyed my hair in my life.
This is your first time?
Of course.
You gotta be kidding.
No. Oh, now I know what you mean by itchy now. Yeah. Itchy, right? Yeah.
Oh my god.
Where's our teammate?
Dude.
Okay,
dude, you look like a Sakuragi.
Huh? No!
No!
First he made it orange, and then he made it red, and then what the fuck is this?
You look like you're from anime, dude. This is Jimmy.
It's Jimmy 2.0.
Jimmy, this is you, dude. Look, it's so much alike, dude.
Man.
Very look alike, Jimmy.
Jimmy, you're so handsome, man. No worry about it.
You know, I dyed my hair once.
You did?
When I was in the sixth grade, my sister dyed it blue. It stayed like that for the first 6 months of the school year. Never again.
So what have you been up to lately? Do you have another tournament coming up?
Yes, in a week. It's in China.
Looked like you were having fun out there in Seattle.
I mean, we were winning at first, then we just lost all of a sudden.
Oh.
Yeah, that was like depressing.
Dang. You're gonna have a comeback, right?
Uh-huh.
When did you cut your hair?
The day we lost, next day. I fell back. Now I was just so angry. I shaved it off.
Yeah, little renewal.
I mean, then I like cried.
Damn, son.
Are you liking it?
Yeah.
It's cool, right?
Uh-huh.
So, Archer, if you weren't playing Dota, what would you do?
I have no idea, because I feel like I change my mind on what I want to do every couple of years, or every couple of months even. Yeah, I don't know, dude. It doesn't seem very fulfilling to just study and study during your golden years, I'd say.
These are golden years.
Yeah, I mean, I think so. Aren't they the golden years, you know, when you just graduate high school and
is
then...
Is he in this golden age? Or is he past it?
What?
This guy.
You pointing at me? Well, my golden years are over, man. It's all downhill from here.
Come on, man.
Hey, Zai, how long do you think you're going to be playing Dota for?
Probably playing for at least, I don't know, 5 more years. That'd be 24. How old are you now, Fear? 29?
28.
Yeah, about that age is probably my limit as well. I mean, I already kind of retired for a year, right?
True.
It was a nice year, to be honest.
What'd you do?
I studied.
I'm not gonna do that.
I actually socialized. I went to the gym.
Yeah.
I sometimes do that too.
My favorite part about being retired now is I'm gonna be able to go to the gym.
Can I come with you?
No, you can't.
Wow.
Did you ever work a day in your life, Arturo?
I think a week at Safeway. I think one day I didn't show up and I didn't even tell him that I'm like quitting or something.
Occasionally this job feels like you're just playing and you don't really contribute to anything. You're just playing a game.
You're entertaining people, dude.
Yeah, I suppose.
You're bringing joy to many by existing, by being yourself. That's wonderful.
I guess it's grown into entertainment, hasn't it?
Yep.
It's pretty weird. What's the worst thing you've signed?
I signed a condom the other day. It was just like happened naturally. He just came up to me, can you sign this? Takes out the condom and be like, holy shit. I'm like, yeah, let's do it. Then he said, can you put for the boys? I'm like, yeah, sure, man. For the boys.
The weird part is that he's going to gonna have sex and suddenly he's going to think about you at like one instance during that.
I want to drink. I'm still jet lagged.
I'm going to go live.
Oh, back and earn, please. Oh, back and earn. Back and earn. If we're drinking later, just don't get too sloppy, like last night. Hi!
Cheers!
Driving car. Aha. Captain Raven. I'm the captain now.
Okay.
Careful, Jimmy, please, careful.
Oh, I don't want to go there. I want to go there, huh?
Okay. Jimmy, you can drive while you're drunk?
No.
Jimmy, it's illegal.
But it's okay, this is Malaysia.
Oh, shit, no.
Make a wish.
Yeah.
You have to bite it and put it out.
Yeah. We're best friends.
Is this real?
What the fuck is going on, dude?
I don't know. Maybe in trouble over here.
Right now, all the guys are preparing for their very first tournament as a team. And the idea of the boot camp is just for all of them to be in the same location, to kind of gel.
Phew, you little fuck, bring back the chair.
What chair?
What the fuck is wrong with you guys?
I'm using the worst fucking chair in this house.
I have the second worst. Hey guys, get in TeamSpeak, please. Thank you.
Artur's been kind of like the team hopper. He left, and then he came back, and then he left again. And I think both times it was like very devastating.
You have to talk to your team, man. I played Oracle once. No, like a 7k average game. I just want to leave.
Whenever you play support in those 7k average games, you always have a jungler. It's GG.
But I'm a real support player.
Universe, he kind of jumped ship and went to Secret this year with Artur, but he came back, so it's okay. I don't know what was going on. I'm sure Artur led him to the dark side or something.
So I was in some might trouble, in it trouble. Seems.
Yeah, I'm dead.
Sorry, man. Oh, I told you guys. It's a support morph.
Oh, fuck off.
So that was a huge question mark. Artur and Zai left our team right before DAC, so we took a chance with this 15-year-old kid who just moved from Pakistan. He had his own play style. He did things nobody else did, and he didn't care if they were the right thing to do. He just did them because it helped him win. And at the end of the day, Dota is about winning.
When we go to tournaments, I don't want to waste time, fucking around. I just want everybody to be focused.
And for Crit, I don't know too much about him. I've never played on a team with him. The guys seem to really believe in him, so I will as well. We'll have to see how he does as a leader.
I think when we're together, at least we should try to make the most of it. That's pretty much it.
I thought you were gonna die.
Yeah. I banged into something. Three.
I don't know, what did you learn from this?
How to fall down and how to get up.
Yeah!
Hey, that's life.
And keep moving forward.
And keep moving forward.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
So it's all bad? No support.
No support offline. I got no support, that's why. Yeah.
The support survived, the carry just died.
Sorry guys, I'm
sorry. So what's the story of how you came to be with Fnatic?
They asked me like 5 times to join Fnatic, but...
Because he's scared of Mushi.
I'm scared of Mushi.
You're scared of him?
Yeah.
Why are you scared of him?
Because he's a legendary player, right? And yeah. This is my idol. That's why I play carry role, because of him. Because he's so good.
Mushi is known as a very strict captain and a teammate. Having a vacation with him, it really changed a lot the way I see him as a person.
supper again?
Yes, of course.
I just want a drink.
Can I have a photo?
Oh, sure.
La 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 la.
Of course, hey.
You. Classic Jimmy.
Classic Jimmy. Good, good, good.
Good, good, good. No beers today.
No beer.
No beers.
For the yacht.
Today is the night where we leave for China to play at MDL, and we're all just like kind of packing up and getting ready to go. Just going through all the motions, finishing up our laundry.
All right, that's it. I gotta change it also.
You packed up already here?
Kind of.
You're amazing here.
Thank you.
Yeah, in the Uber in a half an hour.
By the fire while eating fondue. What you know about me? What you know about you? So hello to my friend. 3, 2. Tonight's gonna be a good night. Tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Here, help me. Here, I don't know the lyrics of this one. When have you ever seen me sing that?
It's gonna be in Boston.
Boston?
Yeah, Boston. It's gonna be from the 7th to 10th of December.
7th through 10th?
Huh? 7th to 10th, like 4 days.
What?
4 days only?
So
yeah.
Short?
Yeah, it's quite short, yeah.
So Jimmy can go home.
Yeah, I guess.
Shit.
Yeah, right after that.
Yeah, I can come back on 26th or 27th.
Yeah,
it's still,
that's about
10 days or more to practice.
I don't know. I don't know about the schedule.
I can get kicked again, right?
No, God. Got BTS or something?
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah, who knows, right?
So tomorrow, Nico and Polo is coming back.
The next day, you schedule our practice on October 1st and we start training. First day, heavy. If it's too much, then we lost track of what we learned before, then we slow down the next day. But first day is okay, I think heavy.
Okay, heavy. Heavy is like what, 7-8 games? Yeah. 6-7 games?
Yeah.
Yeah.
At least 6 games.
Yes.
Okay, finish. Do you think that you should use a silent on Nyx?
I think we can still fight though.
Yeah.
25-18, 35-13.
Oh, I'm
watching my game. Wait, if you Yules and I global, does it still silence?
No.
Yeah.
No.
I think yes.
Yeah, yes.
I think it does.
I think yes, but
hey,
here.
Hey,
I'm pointing top.
I don't have TP. I don't have TP.
What?
Wait, I don't know. I'll go.
Yeah. Wait. Yeah. Go.
What's up?
We never think of anything to do with the draft. We must be aggressive at the early game, or else we just lost a game like that. I like running a lot because when I'm running, I feel like I can think more about what I can do. It's kind of relaxing for me. Yeah, I actually having a big mistake. I will do it over and over again. It's mostly my emotion. It's very hard for us to just go like that.
He fucked up, huh?
Sometimes I get too stressed or something because I'm a very, very hardworking player. And when I put that much effort, I always think that, oh, my team should put the same effort as me.
It's me still.
I know this is a very, very wrong thinking, but I'm still working on it.
Yeah. All right, guys.
Someone else go first.
I'll go first.
Yeah, you go first.
Pump it.
We can completely just destroy the game because Beast can roar someone across the map. We don't have to do all-in moves like where you're a little foreign wisp, where we're not...
Oh, you're saying you shouldn't win aggro.
No, aggro's fine, but like what you do after aggro matters a lot. No,
if we go aggro and then at minute 7 or some shit, I go up here and start pulling and stuff, like they're gonna be 4 heroes up here and it's gonna collapse on our safety.
Time. This is gonna be close.
It's just very stressful.
Alright, good work, guys.
Nice. Nice win, gentlemen.
Oh, we have a day off.
So we don't play tomorrow at all?
We do not play tomorrow.
Alright, massage, badminton.
Massage and badminton.
That's on the schedule tomorrow.
Let's go play badminton tomorrow. You know?
Badminton?
Yeah.
Who the fuck's playing badminton?
Winners?
Have to work on synergy. I mean, we are a new team. I mean, it's only been like, what, 3 weeks? Yeah. We haven't even practiced that much. Communication is not the problem, actually. It's more like getting used to the accent, which is the, yeah, because we come from this different nationality. I mean, these guys don't have the best English, let's face it. Sometimes Jimmy will call teleport, porting. We just call it TP, right? And Jimmy will call it porting, and everybody's like, what?
We're gonna ward in their base, we're gonna smoke inside. Wait, just wait here. It's almost daytime, just
You want us to spam them first? I can X-mark
me. Can you X-mark me and then I try
Mushi,
to burn someone?
We can spam for a while.
You don't tell Mushi what to do, you watch Mushi. What he When he's getting low, you pull him back. Eventually, Ohio and Polo can go
in. It's new.
Yeah, that's why I'm just trying to... So you just understand
From the whole game, I just feel very, very uncomfortable about our communication, about how we play. We just don't know what to do, you know, for most of the time.
One thing to me, though, I think I owe almost 6 level. If it's 6, I don't want to greedy, maybe we'll cover top or either middle.
Are you close? Are you 6 soon, huh?
I already 6.
No, don't ask me now. Don't ask me now. Later
Marping
you ask
DB,
me, I don't steal it.
Marping
I don't steal
DB
it.
Mid. Marping DB mid.
Not now, right?
Starting for the first day, the Nico and Polo already tell me that, oh, yo, you speak too fast.
Remember, they doesn't have any first move, huh? They cannot catch people so
and
easily.
So I'm trying to control myself. I mean, slow down a little bit.
There might be a fight mid. There's no morphling, guys.
No, Bottom is flashing. See, Bottom is flashing.
I forgot.
Look. Coming from behind here.
Can we cover Jimmy to making some good road?
Hey, can we smoke here soon?
Jimmy, I think give me the ops because it's almost morning.
No, it's okay. It's fine.
No, you hold it. Okay. Give me the ops. But for all of us, after we have a discussion, we feel just only maybe like, we just have to play more together.
I'm porting.
Guys, port now. Draw is coming.
Kill. Draw first.
Okay.
Bad call, man.
I think we just needed to.
I think it's fine if you just impale.
It's Evil Geniuses going against Team Secret. And what a doozy of a match it's going to be.
Alright, so...
I'm so hungry, Jimmy.
My draft analysis here, guys. We put on PPD's perspective.
Get his ass, dude.
Alright, I'm getting his ass.
Are you serious, Crit? He is blasting out everything he can right now with the purifying flame.
Wow, Crit. Holy shit.
Victor directly to come through. Arteezy cleaning up the rest of the mess from behind. And that will be games. EG will take this one. And they move on to face Newbie.
Game is over, boys.
Roll out. Yeah, sure.
Oh, thank you.
I have you.
Thank you.
Is there a safe area or some shit?
Yeah, in the van.
I'm surprised they're not running after us or some shit.
These fucking mosquitoes in here, guys.
I have no idea what you're saying.
Mosquito, whatever the fuck you call them. Mosquitoes or some
mosquito.
Shit.
Mosquito.
Mosquitoes, there you go, Fear. Thanks for the English lessons.
I mean, I had no idea what you're saying. A mosquito could be anything.
Yeah, I don't know, Fear.
Stop yelling.
Sorry, Fear.
Need to try the oriental touch massage next time.
What?
The oriental touch.
What's the oriental touch here?
It's the name of the massage.
It she touches your orients?
Oh, for sure.
Get out! Get out!
It's just a fly, dude.
Dude, fucking flies are the scariest shit ever.
We're going straight inside, no signing, guys.
Winner bracket final. It's Evil Geniuses going against Newbie. Winner of this moves on into the grand final for a best of five. Some of the most MMR you'll see on the planet.
Sumail tries to get a piece of the action.
All of Newbie are there waiting for him and just punch him in the nose.
Now Sumail and Arteezy both have to tag team him, but he's going to be able to get out the tornado. He gets the false promise and says, back the hell off.
What?
And it is just nonstop. Don't even try it. They cannot do a thing about it.
I have never seen a single player.
He made them look silly.
Game over.
Might want to go ball inside.
I mean, they should not have won that game for sure. He made like way too many mistakes.
We have a signing session right now.
Perfect time.
Excuse us, guys. Thanks, guys.
Okay.
我只是想尝试积极进步，然后今天就变成point out，我有这个问题，然后我想去，我也不知道怎么去跟你讲，哦，我没有问题啊，我会去进步，我不想讲话。我知道哪一个你是很勤劳，我知道哪一个你是有火，我知道哪一个你是没有 motivation，我都知道。但现在的你，你觉得不觉得你自己真是？但问题是，我确实没像以前
motivation，但是现在最近。 我已经在push我自己了，所以我只能跟你讲，你给我一点时间，就这样子。所以我一直跟你讲，给我一点时间。我只是在 push 自己。我承认 TI6 回来我有点懒。你懂。回来过休息了两个礼拜，我自己都不赞同我们要休息那么久，对吗？我都出生这么久，没有办法。没有办法吗？是不是 ？OK， 现在我回来了，我正在尝试着去 push 自己出来了的。所以我只能跟你讲，你给我一点时间，就这样。
我没有讲不给你时间，现在我只能给时间罢了。但是在这段时间以来。 我肯定也是 balance 不到我自己，我只能忍。你跟你女朋友一起的时候，我也是想跟你讲了的。我因为我看得出，因为我懂这些问题。但是我直到今天我才point out跟你讲。我不是讲没有给你时间，把我是忍到今天了。今天我跟你讲了过后，我不会再跟你讲了，因为我觉得我不想让他们三个失望，我不想让他们三个外国人飞来这里。 我看到他们的付出，我做不到东西，这个就看你自己想，就看你自己决定。我跟你讲过，今天我跟你讲过的话，我不会再跟你讲任何关于这种问题了的。你如果相信我讲话，不相信我讲话也是 up to you。因为今天我相信，今天过后我们的感情我不懂会变成怎样。OK， so I think we should talk a little bit about the team.
Well, something is clearly wrong with our team, whether it's how we play, our play style, not thinking the same thing, on the same page. We're not building chemistry now. We're just playing all as individuals. Like, we make plays. Maybe it's two pairs, like me and Polo and then Nico and Ohio, for example. And then when we all four want to work together, it's a very big mess. I don't know how you guys feel, if you're on the same, if you're thinking on the same page as me. I see EG or OG sometimes getting outdrafted, yet they know how to win the game because they know how to play together.
Why is always you two following us? Why not you are making command and we follow you?
You really want me to command?
I want everyone in here speaking loud and command.
It's just facts. We're not the most individually skilled team. We have skill, we are professionals, but are we the highest skilled team? No, it's a very easy answer and it's true.
This is why that every one of us should understand what we want to do in game. I'm not a 9k player. I'm not a super strong player. Why I gonna win the champion? So what if you guys ask the same question for yourself? Why?
The lower bracket final, and it's come down to this. Game number three. EG going against OG here.
They believe they lost the first game off of execution, not strategy. They firmly believe this.
This is where they swag and they intentionally leave us the exact same draft just to prove it.
Taking a page out of Secret's book, they do the five-man movement right down the mid lane, and the cross pass, huge stun comes out. Arteezy looked to go for him, but guess who was there once again? It's Universe to quickly shut down S4 as he's done all this game.
And EG are sprinting across the finish line.
Well, it looks like they've done it, and they are going to be squaring up against Newbie in the grand final.
Every time I look at S4, she's fucking laughing.
Yeah. Finally, in the grand finals, you're going up against Newbie, and they did well against you yesterday. Do you have any adjustments that you'd like to share with us? Or
we looked at the games, we see what we kind of did wrong. We're going to try to fix it today.
All right, best of luck against Newbie in the finals.
Thank you.
Welcome to the grand finals now of the MDL LAN. We've got Newbie versus Evil Geniuses. The last time these guys met, Newbie looked kind of on another level. Are EG going to be able to step their game back up? Arteezy needs help. It doesn't look like he's going to get it. KP comes over the cross side just in time. Oh. Zai with the save. Artor survives. The core to U9. Out comes the stun gauge from Sunbell. They're found the by Stealer. They're chasing down KP as well. EG team wiping Newbie. And GG, well played is cool. Geniuses have done it. Artor and the boys take their win here at MDL LAN, Andy, and in what spectacular fashion as well.
I miss the feeling of winning and not feeling anything, actually. It's nice. When you win, you don't care.
It has been 8 months.
Is this one LAN?
Yeah, same for you.
Shut up, dude.
Let me know when you guys are ready.
All right, ready.
Ready.
It's a question for Zai. Compared to the squad going into TI6, how is this team better or superior?
This is going to be interesting.
I think it's too soon to say if it's better or superior than the one we had at TI. The only difference, I suppose, is PPD out and crit in. And you know, so far there hasn't been a huge difference. We're still winning. Fury is still with us. I think time will tell, and with time, maybe more apparent differences will be seen with the previous squad and this one. But for now, it's pretty much not that different. Yeah.
就是现在说有很大的区别或优势还是有点太早。
So what me, man? Why not you?
状态还可以，一直打的还可以。现在还说明说有很大的变化或优势。
Oh, whatever.
we really have to work on synergy. I mean, we are a new team. I mean, it's only been 3 weeks. We haven't even practiced that much. Communication is not the problem, actually. It's more like getting used to the accent, which is the, because we come from this different nationality. I mean, these guys don't have the best English, let's face it. Sometimes Jimmy would call teleport, porting. We just call it TP, right? And Jimmy would call it porting, and everybody's like, what?
We're gonna ward in their base, we're gonna smoke inside. Wait, just wait here. It's almost daytime.
You want us to spam them first? I can X-mark Mookie.
Can you X-mark me and then I try
Mushi,
to burn someone?
I X-mark you. We can spam for a while.
You don't tell Mushi what to do. You watch Mushi. When he's getting low, you pull him back. Eventually, Ohio and Polo can go in.
It's new.
Yeah, that's why I'm just trying to... So you just understand
Sorry.
It.
From the whole game, I just feel very, very uncomfortable about our communication, about how we play. We just don't know what to do, you know, for most of the time.
One thing still middle. I think I owe almost 6 level. If it's 6, I don't want to greedy. I will cover top or either middle.
You're close. Oh, you're 6 soon, huh?
I already 6.
No, don't ask me now. Don't ask me now. Later you ask me, I go steal it.
Marplim DB mid.
Not now, right?
Starting from the first day, the Nico and Polo already tell me that, yo, you speak too fast.
Remember, they doesn't have any first move, huh? They cannot catch people so easily.
So I'm trying to control myself. I mean, slow down a little bit.
There might be a fight mid. There's no morphling, guys.
No, Bottle is flashing. See, Bottle is flashing.
I forgot.
Look, coming from behind here.
Can we cover Jimmy to making some good road?
Hey, can we smoke here soon?
Jimmy, I think give me the ops because it's almost morning.
No, it's okay. It's fine.
No, you hold it. Okay. Give me the ops. But for all of us, after we have a discussion, we feel just only maybe like, we just have to play more together.
I'm porting.
Guys, port now. Draw is coming.
Kill. Draw first.
Okay.
Nice call, man.
I think we just needed to.
I think it's fine if you just impale.
It's Evil Geniuses going against Team Secret. And what a doozy of a match it's going to be.
All right, so
I'm so hungry, Jimmy.
My draft analysis here, guys. We put on PPD's perspective.
Get his ass, dude.
All right, I'm getting his ass.
Are you serious, Crit? He is blasting out everything he can right now with the purifying flame.
Wow, Crit! Holy shit!
Victor directly come through. Arteezy cleaning up the rest of the mess from behind. And that will be game. EG will take this one. And they move on to face Newbie.
Game is over, boys.
Roll out. Yeah, sure.
Oh, thank you.
I have you.
Oh. Thank you.
Is there a safe area or some shit?
Yeah, in the van.
I was surprised they're not running after us or some shit.
There's fucking mosquitoes in here, guys.
I have no idea what you're saying.
Mosquito, whatever the fuck you call them. Mosquitoes or some
mosquito.
Shit.
Mosquito.
Mosquitoes, there you go, Fear. Thanks for the English lessons.
I mean, I had no idea what you're saying. A mosquito could be anything.
Yeah, I don't know, Fear.
Stop yelling.
Sorry, Fear.
Need to try the Oriental Touch massage next time.
What?
The Oriental Touch.
What's the Oriental Touch for?
It's the name of the massage.
If she touches your orient?
Oh, for sure.
Get out!
Just a fly, dude.
Dude, fucking flies are the scariest shit ever.
We're going straight inside, no signing, guys.
Winner bracket final. It's Evil Geniuses going against Newbie. Winner of this moves on into the grand final for a best of five. Some of the most MMR you'll see on the planet.
Sumail tries to get a piece of the action.
All of Newbie are there waiting for him and just punch him in the nose.
Now Sumail and Arteezy both have to tag team him, but he's going to be able to get out the tornado. He gets the false promise and says, back the hell off.
What?
And it is just nonstop. Don't even try it. They cannot do a thing about it.
I have never seen a single player.
He made them
utterly
look silly.
Game over.
My one took a ball this time.
I mean, they should not have won that game for sure. Yeah. Huh? We made like way too many mistakes.
We have a signing session right now.
Perfect time.
Excuse us, guys. Thanks, guys.
Okay.
Thanks, guys.
是很勤劳，我知道哪一个你是有火，我知道哪一个你是没有 motivation， 我都知道。但现在的你，你觉得不觉得你自己真的是？但问题是我确实没像以前
motivation， 但是现在最近我已经在 push 我自己啊，所以我只能跟你讲，你给我一点时间，就这样子。所以我一直跟你讲，给我一点时间。我只是在 push 自己，我承认 TI6 回来我有点懒。
你懂。
回来过后休息那两个礼拜，我自己都不赞同我们要休息那么久，对吗？我都出生这么久。
没有办法，是不是
？OK， 现在我回来了，我正在尝试着去 push 自己出来了的，所以我只能跟你讲，你给我点时间，就这样。我没有讲不给你时间，现在我只能给时间罢了。但是在这段时间以来，我肯定也是
balance 不到我自己，我只能忍。你跟你女朋友一起的时候，我也是想跟你讲了的，因为我看得出，因为我懂这些问题，但是我直到今天我才碰到跟你讲。 我不是讲没有给你时间，但我是忍到今天了。今天我跟你讲了过后，我不会再跟你讲了，因为我觉得我不想让他们三个失望，我不想让他们三个外国人飞来这里，我看到他们的付出，我做不到东西。这个就看你自己想，就看你自己决定。我跟你讲过，今天我跟你讲过的话，我不会再跟你讲任何关于这种问题了的。你如果是 相信我讲话，不相信我讲话也是 up to you。 因为今天我相信，今天过后我们的感情我不懂会变成怎样。 OK， so I think we should talk a little bit about the team.
Well, something is clearly wrong with our team. Whether it's how we play, our play style, not thinking the same thing, on the same page, we're not building chemistry now. We're just playing all as individuals. Like, we make plays. Maybe it's two pairs, like me and Polo and then Nico and Ohio, for example. And then when we all four want to work together, it's a very big mess. I don't know how you guys feel, if you're thinking on the same page as me.
Polo hair?
It's kind of very long.
Yeah, it's too long.
Is that long? Yeah.
I think so.
It's long and thick, you know?
Please make me look, how do you say handsome in Chinese? Leng Chai. Make me Leng Chai. Worst case, I just shave it all off. Oh no.
Very itchy.
Itchy?
Yeah, it's itchy. Itchy as fuck.
I've never dyed my hair in my life.
Is this your first time?
Of course.
You gotta be kidding.
No. Really? Oh, now I know what you mean by itchy now.
Yeah. Itchy, right?
Yeah.
噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔噔
Dude,
you look like a Sakuragi.
No!
It's not Sakuragi!
First he made it orange, and then he made it red, and then what the fuck is this?
You look like you're from anime, dude.
This is Jimmy. It's Jimmy 2.0.
Jimmy, this is you, dude. Look. It's so much alike, dude.
Man.
Very look alike, Jimmy. You know that
character, Jimmy, you're so handsome, man. No worry about it.
You know, I dyed my hair once.
You did?
When I was in the sixth grade, my sister dyed it blue. It stayed like that for the first 6 months of the school year. Never again.
So what have you been up to lately? Do you have another tournament coming up?
Yes, in a week. It's in China.
Looked like you were having fun out there in Seattle.
Yeah, we were winning at first, then we just lost all of a sudden. Yeah, that was like depressing.
Dang. Are you going to have a comeback, right?
Uh-huh.
When did you cut your hair?
The day we lost, next day. Like, I traveled back. Now I was just so angry. Like, I shaved it off.
Yeah, little renewal.
I mean, then I like cried.
Damn, son.
Are you liking it?
Yeah.
It's cool, cool, right?
Uh-huh.
So, Archer, if you weren't playing Dota, what would you do?
I have no idea, because I feel like I change my mind on what I want to do every couple of years, or every couple of months even. Yeah, I don't know, dude. It doesn't seem very fulfilling to just study and study during your golden years, I'd say.
Are these our golden years?
Yeah, I mean, like, I think so. Aren't they the golden years, you know, when you just graduate high school and
is
then...
Is he in his golden age? Or is he past it?
What?
This guy.
You pointing at me? Well, my golden years are over, man. It's all downhill from here.
Come on, man.
Hey, Zai, how long do you think you're going to be playing Dota for?
Probably playing for at least, I don't know, 5 more years. That'd be 24. How old are you now, Fear? 29?
28.
28. Yeah, about that age is probably my limit as well. I mean, I already kind of retired for a year, right?
True.
It was a nice year, to be honest.
What'd you do?
I studied.
I'm not gonna do that.
I actually socialized. I went to the gym.
Yeah.
I sometimes do that too.
My favorite part about being retired now is I'm gonna be able to go to the gym.
Can I come with you?
No, you can't.
Wow.
Did you ever work a day in your life, Arturo?
I think a week at Safeway. I think one day I didn't show up and I didn't even tell them that I'm like quitting or something.
Occasionally this job feels like you're just playing and you don't really contribute to anything. You're just playing a game.
You're entertaining people, dude.
Yeah, I suppose.
You're bringing joy to many by existing, by being yourself. That's wonderful.
I guess it's grown into entertainment, hasn't it?
Yep.
It's pretty weird. What's the worst thing you've signed?
I signed a condom the other day. It was just like happened naturally. He just came up to me, can you sign this? Takes out the condom and be like, holy shit. I'm like, yeah, let's do it. Then he said, can you put for the boys? I'm like, yeah, sure, man. For the boys.
The weird part is that he's gonna like, he's gonna have sex and suddenly he's gonna think about you at like one instance during that.
I wanna drink.
I'm still jet lagged.
You don't go more life.
Oh, back and earn, please. Back and earn. Back and earn. If we're drinking later, just don't get too sloppy, like last night. Hi! Cheers!
Captain Raven. I'm the captain now.
Okay.
Careful, Jimmy, please, careful.
No, I don't want to go there. I want to go there, huh? Okay.
Jimmy, you can drive while you're drunk?
No.
Jimmy, it's illegal.
But it's okay, this is Malaysia.
Oh shit, no.
Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday.
make the wish.
Yeah.
Make a wish.
Make a wish.
Yeah.
You have to bite it and put it out. That's all.
We're best friends.
Pussy.
Is this real?
What the fuck is going on, dude?
I don't know. Maybe in trouble over here.
Right now, all the guys are preparing for their very first tournament as a team. And the idea of the boot camp is just for all of them to be in the same location, to kind of gel.
Phew, you little fuck, bring back the chair.
What chair?
What the fuck is wrong with you guys?
I'm using the worst fucking chair in this house.
I have the second worst. Hey guys, get in TeamSpeak, please. Thank you.
Artur has been kind of like the team hopper. He left and then he came back and then he left again. And I think both times was like very devastating.
You have to talk to your team, man. I played Oracle once. No, like a 7k average game. I just want to leave.
Whenever he plays a board in those 7k average games, you always have a jungler. It's GG.
But I'm a real support player.
Universe, he kind of jumped ship and went to Secret this year with Artur. But he came back, so it's okay. I don't know what was going on. I'm sure Artur led him to the dark side or something.
So I was in some trouble, it seems.
Yeah, I'm dead.
Sorry, man.
Oh, I told you guys. It's a support morph.
Oh, fuck off.
Smell was a huge question mark. Artur and Zai left our team right before DAC. So we took a chance with this 15-year-old kid who just moved from Pakistan. He had his own play style. He did things nobody else did, and he didn't care if they were the right thing to do. He just did them because it helped him win. And at the end of the day, Dota's about winning.
When we go to tournaments, I don't want to waste time, fucking around. I just want everybody to be focused.
And for Crit, I don't know too much about him. I've never played on a team with him. The guys seem to really believe in him, so. I will as well. We'll have to see how he does as a leader.
Reforming the team again like this, it means that we have to start from the scratch again. And everything that we have done till now has to be redone again. And that's gonna be really, really difficult.
I mean, for us, this is our first time actually playing together, seriously, I would say. We did some online scrims before we got here, but the conditions weren't great.
Are you excited about sharing a room with
them? I mean, we used to share rooms a lot. We shared rooms on Secret, occasionally on EG, so something new. Of course, having a solo room is nice, but this is building team spirit, right? Team morale.
I can't brush my teeth, sir. There we go. I didn't know.
Artur, give us a rundown of what you got packed, man.
My mom packed for me, so I don't really know. Just got some shorts. Got enough clothing to last a couple of days, then I have to do the laundry.
Do you know how to do laundry?
Yeah.
Serious?
Just checking.
Shows you right here. It's like cool, pretty cool, long sleeves. I think I'm the only Dota player with long sleeve jersey. Jacket from TI6. It's like super hard to think of any other nick. Like no one has their first name as their nick. So it's like pretty cool too. Just have something unique. So that's why I chose Sumail. Can you tell us how you decided to pack what you packed? I mean, I didn't even pack my bag. It was my mom. So, and like she put everything I had. So that's pretty much it.
We're headed over to the Chinese consulate to get visas for
Ludwig, Andreas, and Sumail. This is a pretty standard part of the process.
Two sets of passport photos, please.
The European countries don't get 10-year visas generally, so you have to renew them a couple times a year. And Sumail, who has a Pakistani passport, is a constant problem. So for every place that we travel, he has to go get a visa. It is a constant challenge, but well worth it for Sumail.
Have a good day. Appreciate it.
Who's the best singer right now?
Singer?
Yeah.
Right now?
Yeah. Personally, I like my boy Zayn, and then Bieber. And then who's there? Yeah, it's like not many, I guess.
I wouldn't say they're good singers.
Wait, what do you say?
I wouldn't say they're good singers.
Are you serious?
Their music is fine, but they're not like great singers.
All right, man.
That's just my opinion.
Did you see the ESPN article with Jeremy Lin and VG?
I didn't read it, but I saw it. It was only a matter of time, I think, until he invested in a team.
Who is Jeremy Lin?
Jeremy Lin is a,
that's like, a great
famous
boy.
NBA basketball player. He actually plays Dota.
Oh, he does?
Yeah, that's the thing. Like, he grew up like playing Dota like with his friends.
Oh, that's cool. So, like,
he's comparing NBA players to Dota heroes.
Wait, you're saying Razor is like...
Steph Curry.
Steph Curry.
No way. Oh, Kobe's
juggernaut is Kobe.
I would say Kobe would be juggernaut.
I could see that.
Yeah, we actually live on Haight-Ashbury. It's a pretty historic intersection for the city. Jimi Hendrix is right here. A block up the street is the Grateful Dead house, which I imagine people watching this probably won't even know who they are, but they're a pretty big monumental band for this area. You know, I myself don't really know them that well, but I listened to their music the other day when we were driving to Vegas. And
you're literally wearing a Haight-Ashbury shirt. What? And you're like, I don't know who the Grateful... Whatever.
Times are changing.
Whatever.
You act like everybody knows the Grateful Dead. You don't even know the Grateful Dead.
Oh my God, I know the Grateful Dead. They were telling me how no one knows who Jimi Hendrix is. They're like, he's so like...
I'm not saying nobody knows who Jimi Hendrix is. I'm just saying, like, if you asked like today's teenagers who Jimi Hendrix was, they probably would not know.
I feel like it's like Elvis. Like, I feel like everyone knows who Jimi Hendrix
is. No, he's not Elvis.
Unreal.
I don't know when I'm able to see her, and she never knows when she's going to see me. It's like I told her whenever an event in Canada or US, like, I can come visit for a couple days.
It's hard, but at least you and I are making it work somehow.
But she's like, what's really a couple days when you're missing a month or two or whatever it is?
Good night.
I love you.
I love you too.
She graduates in June, and she told me it'd mean everything to her if I could make it, and told her it's like, I can't give you an... That slip kind of sucks sometimes, because like with Dota, you don't know how the season's going to be, what kind of tournaments are coming up. No one wants to be that guy to like, hey, like, let's call this off because I have something important to attend to. Well, yeah, I just hope we'll see what happens, but at the end of the day, it's pretty tough.
Roll toward the back. We're not going to fill it up. It's got a lot of seats, but...
You didn't shave, huh? Why would I shave, man? Girls dig mustaches. Word up.
What about half a mustache?
Work in progress.
You gotta start somewhere.
Be good. All right. Yeah, I've got everybody in a row. Awesome. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Dude, $6 million Earthshaker, Eccleston, that's amazing. Dude, I jumped out of my seat when that happened.
All right, everyone, who is ready to play with the best Dota team? You ready?
How many games are we doing?
I have no idea.
I want to play all day.
He has a great mustache.
Yeah, you like it? Don't encourage him, man.
Wait, the cheats are on? Cheats, oh, shit, cheats were on for last game.
Wait, are we randoming or what?
I'm not randoming.
Come on.
I'm playing Pudge, dude.
What? No, you can't play Pudge. Yeah, that's random, man.
I mean, I'm still going to do everything that I did before except for actually play. I'm just going to be like just in the background, you know, and just kind of just like helping them prepare for games. So I'll still be part of it without having to play, which is pretty cool. I don't know what I'm doing, guys.
Are you going jungle?
I don't know. I don't got jungle items.
I guess you can do it.
All right.
Let him have it.
All right, Peter's getting a double-double. No lettuce, no tomato. And a cheeseburger.
We have a cheeseburger.
With everything.
Everything.
And animal style.
Animal style.
4x4 animal style.
4x4 animal style.
Then two double doubles, no tomato, no onion.
Small chocolate, dude.
A small chocolate milkshake.
Small chocolate milkshake, please. Hey, thank you. That's everything? Perfect. Thank you.
In America, everything is finger food.
Are these the colors? Yeah. Maybe this.
What the fuck?
I'm so scared.
New hair, new life.
New hair, new life.
I never have this kind of hair before. I need to pull over here.
I can't start this interview without asking you this question. How does it feel like to return to EG for the third time?
Well, it feels okay to be back in EG. Actually, this is hard to answer, man. Oh my god. Yeah, I need to think about this. So I'm trying to think of something to say that I haven't said before about last time I left So it's actually quite hard.
So I'll ask you the question again. How does it feel to be back to EG for the third time? Do you have any extra pressure or expectations?
I guess the most pressure I ever felt after replacing someone on EG was after they just won TI, and I think that went pretty well.
This time around, we have to step up as players and learn how to lead more. Both me and Crit have that responsibility and more now compared to them, because we lost Fear and PPD as players who are both very crucial in our, you know, decision making.
As you're all from different backgrounds, how you guys agree on ideas and training and stuff like that?
Well, the idea behind how Fnatic works and all, it seems very good right now. The fact, like, we have Mushi and Ohio from Malaysia, and we have two Filipinos, and right now it really comes a lot on Mushi because he's the most experienced player. And his knowledge, like, we're very, very open for criticism as well, which is going to help us excel in the future. This season, I'm very optimistic about it. Our goal is top three.
Well, it'd be nice to go to the grand finals for the third time, I can't lie, but I think we're capable of winning for sure. I also think we're capable of losing, so...
Alright, that's it. Awesome. Thanks.
Yes. Awesome.
Used to be the captain of the Dota team, and now I'm fixing the toilet. That's just how it goes. All right, what are we doing?
Wow.
What just happened? Where did that go? Where did that come from?
Have you done this before?
I've never done this before. I used to play Dota for millions of dollars.
No
one will ever believe me. Most people are kind of like surprised I would leave the team. Especially because there wasn't really any signs of me like retiring, so I'm still like only 24 years old, and I've only been playing Dota for like 3 years, when other people have been playing for like close to a decade. But everyone's saying really nice things for the most part.
Someone's like, it's a good time for him. Yeah, 24, yeah. He was about to get too old.
Gotta start settling down.
Yeah.
All right. I think we're good.
EG is just the whole front page today by the look of it.
Oh, I have an AMA request thread. I just saw it.
Look at this, top comment of the AMA request. PPD will own EG one day. Mark my words.
That's an interesting philosophy. Who is that?
Whammy Barnett.
Whammy Barnett has some good insight.
Whammy Barnett, smart.
Smart man.
Welcome back. You're going to be staying in your old room.
Exciting.
Yeah, it's a little cleaner than you left it, I believe.
A place I once called home.
I thought about it last year, to be honest, to retire, but I kind of still really wanted to play, and so I pushed myself through all my year, but I need to give myself like a proper break and heal my arm.
I don't know if you want to take like the outside or the inside.
Probably just the corner, maybe over there, away from everyone.
Away from everyone?
Yeah.
I think I could definitely be happy being a coach. Like, it's like the next best thing to playing. If I can do anything that'll still keep me close to the game and part of the competition, I probably will do it.
Right now, all the guys are preparing for their very first tournament as a
surprise,
team.
Surprise, surprise. Welcome back.
They're boot camping at our team house in Alameda.
Oh, this place is so fancy, huh?
Yeah.
And the idea of the boot camp is just for all of them to get together and figure out how exactly they want to play together.
Hey, you stole Peter's seat?
Is that Peter's seat?
You are the new Peter?
Dan, that's me.
You know, make sure that they're getting along and having fun, but also to just have like a very focused practice routine where they wake up, play a couple scrims, and at night they play pubs. Just really focus on just Dota and not have any other distractions.
Am I sitting here? I don't know. Oh, shit.
Dang.
Jimmy just arrived. He just texted me, hi. That's pretty much it, so.
What are you gonna text him back?
Where you at?
Let's go, man.
yeah, I didn't expect PPD to retire, dude.
You expected them?
No, I didn't expect that. I mean, I didn't see that coming.
I told you.
You told me?
Yeah, I told you PPD's out.
I thought you were joking, dude.
No, I was like,
no, this doesn't make sense to me. I mean, he's like Peter in EG right now, you know? He's like the face of EG.
So what do we have aside from this photo shoot and that's it?
It's photo shoot, and then you guys are going to the island.
After the photo shoot, it's like, and
even after the photo shoot,
looks like a zombie.
Don't worry, dude. They put makeup on you. It's all good.
You know you're very slow.
What?
You know you're very slow.
I know, I saw, I was like, what the fuck, you guys are already, I'm already.
So, our team had a massive change. I mean, we had a three-player change, which is a bit unfortunate, I suppose. We were hoping to rebuild the team around Amushi in Ohio. It was kind of tough to look for three players, especially in this shuffle, because this shuffle has been, very bluntly put, very messy. The messiest one I've ever seen. We don't know who is going where. It was insane, you know. At the end, Mushi likes to play with Demon, Jimmy. And Jimmy's confirmation is pretty much AO's confirmation as well, because they are a support duo and they're supposed to stay together. And we picked Raven. Raven is probably the most stable carry in the Philippines right now. The small problem about Raven is only his age, because he's 17. He's turning 18 in about a week time.
I see the debut. When you get it right,
yeah. The biggest challenge that the team is going to face is basically playing to the level that the previous team played again. All the accomplishments took a lot of months to build. Small details, all the small details along the way took like a whole year to build. And basically,
I think when we're together at least, we should try to make the most of it. That's pretty much it.
I thought you were gonna die.
Yeah. I banged into something. Gee.
I don't know, what did you learn from this?
How to fall down and how to get up.
Yeah!
Hey, that's life.
And keep moving forward.
And keep moving forward.
Okay. My test driver here.
So it's all bad? No support. No support. Yeah.
I got no support, support. That's yeah. Why.
The support survived, the carry didn't die.
Sorry guys.
Yeah. So what's the story of how you came to be with Fnatic?
They asked me like 5 times to join Fnatic, but
he's scared of Mushi.
You're scared of
Mushi? Yeah.
Why are you scared of Mushi?
Because he's a legendary player, right? And yeah. This is my idol. That's why I play carry role, because of him. Because he's so good.
Mushi is known as a very strict captain and a teammate. Having a vacation with him, it really changed a lot the way I see him as a person.
Supper again?
Yes, of course.
I just want a drink.
Can I have a popo?
Oh, sure.
La 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 la.
Of course, hey.
Hey. Raven. You. Classic Jimmy.
Classic Jimmy. Good. Good,
good. Good, good, good.
One, two,
no beers today.
No beer.
No beer.
No beers.
Where they at?
Today is the night where we leave for China to play at MDL, and we're all just like kind of packing up and getting ready to go. Just going through all the motions, finishing up our laundry. All
right, that's it. I gotta change those, so.
You packed up already here?
Kind of.
You're amazing here.
Thank you. Yeah, in the Uber in a half an hour.
by the fire while eating fondue. What you know about me, what you know about you. So hello to my friend, 3, 2. I like to be. Tonight's gonna be a good night. Tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Here, help me. Here, I don't know the lyrics of this one. When have you ever seen me sing that?
It's gonna be in Boston.
Boston?
Yeah, Boston. It's gonna be from the 7th to 10th of December.
7th through 10th?
Huh? 7th to 10th, like 4 days.
What? 4 days only?
So
yeah.
Short?
Yeah, it's quite short, yeah.
So Jimmy can go home.
Yeah, I guess. Shit. Yeah, right after that.
Yeah, I can come back on 26 or 27.
Yeah,
it's still right, 10 yeah. days or more to practice.
I don't know. I don't know about the schedule.
I can get kicked again, right?
No, got BTS or something?
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah, who knows, right?
So tomorrow, Nico and Polo is coming back.
The next day, you schedule our practice on October 1st and we start training. First day heavy, if it's too much, then we lost track of what we learned before, then we slow down the next day. But first day is okay, I think heavy.
Okay, heavy. Heavy is like what, 7-8 games? Yeah. 6-7 games?
Yeah.
Yeah.
At least 6 games.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Do you think that you should use a silent on next?
I think we can still fight though.
Yeah.
25-18, 35-13.
What happened?
I'm watching my game. Wait. So, if you Yules and I global, does it still silence?
No.
Yeah.
No.
I think yes.
Yeah. Yes. No, because
I think it does.
It's
I think yes, but here.
I'm
pointing top. I'm pointing top. I'm pointing top.
I don't have TP. I don't have TP.
What?
Wait. I can do it.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Yeah. Go.
What's up?
We never think of anything to do with the draft. We must be aggressive at the early game, or else we just lost a game like that. I like running a lot because when I'm running, I feel like I can think more about what I can do. It's kind of relaxing for me. Yeah, I actually having a big mistake. I will do it over and over again. It's mostly my emotion. It's very hard for us to just go like that.
He fucked up, huh?
Sometimes I get too stressed or something because I'm a very, very hardworking player. And when I put that much effort, I always think that, oh, my team should put the same effort as me.
It's me.
I know this is a very, very wrong thinking, but I'm still working on it.
Yeah. Alright, guys.
Someone else go first.
I'll go first.
Yeah, you go first.
Check on set, pump it.
We can completely just destroy the game because Beast can roar someone across the map. We don't have to do all-in moves like where you're level 4 and Wisp where we're not.
Oh, you're saying you shouldn't win aggro.
No, aggro is fine, but like after what you do after aggro matters a lot.
No, if we go aggro and then at minute 7 or some shit, I go up here and start pulling and stuff, like they're gonna be 4 heroes up here and it's gonna collapse on our safety.
Time. This is gonna be close.
It's just very stressful.
Oh. Alright, good work, guys.
Nice win, gentlemen.
Oh, we have a day off.
So we don't play tomorrow at all?
We do not play tomorrow.
Alright, massage, badminton.
Massage and badminton.
That's on the schedule tomorrow.
Let's go play badminton tomorrow. You know?
Badminton?
Yeah.
Who the fuck's playing badminton?
Winners?